I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Listen,
Devin, that's my job. Your job.
No.
I'm gonna tell you what you're supposed to do with me, Devin. You're supposed to leverage me. You're supposed to leverage me. I'm gonna teach you, Devin.
This thing about you, and this is the thing about you too. Is your thing running? This is the thing about you is. Nobody should ever be able to tell you they did nothing to him, and you've never seen him do nothing to a fighter like him. You got to tell him, you got to see it. So if you had seen Teofimo Lopez, where did, okay, no. But really, right? They've got a graveyard full of them. You just named it. You named the couple, right? You don't want to mention Floyd.
It's gonna be you in a couple of years. What's up, Tank?
You get your credentials revoked. You too, and that's your man. But your credentials is gonna run. You come to our show. Listen, you gonna come to our show. You have credentials, and it ain't gonna matter what you say. We don't want you to tell the truth.
Hey, Dave. I'm gonna do like this for y'all. Since y'all think it ain't no love over here. Put the quiet on here.
You know what I'm saying? How did y'all meet?
Hold on. I wanna say something too. Yeah. A lot of people, they want me and this dude to be in beef. They want us to be, you know what I'm saying, going at it on Twitter. Cause we young, you know what I'm saying? We some handsome, flashy, light-skinned dudes, you know what I'm saying? We getting a lot of money and we doing some big things. And it's only, the sky's limit for both of us, all three of us, for real. So, you know, they want us to be, but you know what I'm saying? We're going to keep on winning, keep on getting money, and keep doing what we're supposed to.
And ain't know what else going to happen with an OG in this corner, and I'm OG in this corner. And never in the future. It ain't going to never happen. It's business.
You got it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
How did y'all meet Devin? Devin was fired. Howard was from like, Young. Yeah.
What did you think of the fight tonight?
It was good. It was good.
Entertaining. The energy was good.
It was great. It was a great fight. Robert did his thing. Mikey did his thing. It was a boxer needed this tonight.
What did you think of Mikey calling out Earl Spence?
Mikey feel like he can do it. Then first you got to believe in yourself. And if you believe in yourself, then
I know you're wearing sunglasses. Look at all this ice.
Yeah. You know,
how's your daughter doing right now?
My daughter great. She back home with her mom. I can't wait to go back and see her.
When you go back tomorrow? Huh? Tomorrow?
Yeah, I'm going back tomorrow on Monday.
Yeah. What do you wish AB for his birthday tonight?
Be taking AB up in the car too because they didn't come to my training camp. So I got a fight with them. They didn't come to my training camp, so I got a bone to pick with them guys.
Robert, right here.
He's right there, AB.
Been in the ring with Mikey for 12 rounds. Just your assessment with that. How do you feel he does against Spence? And that fight where it comes
in. See, Mikey, I've been in the ring with Spence too. You know, he sparred, a few years back when as amateurs, and Spence always had this type of power, you know, tremendous power, and, Mikey has his mind made up, of going up in weight classes, you know, but, you know, that's what boxing's for. Boxing, you know, champions believe they can take on other champions, so there you have it. You know, I tip my hat off to him. You know, you seen it tonight. He's a true champion, true warrior. So, but you know, Errol Spence, he's a different breed. He's an animal.
Did the news of we all found out earlier this week that Mikey doesn't do setups in camp? Did that kind of affect your game plan as far as going in? Because obviously you were doing some body work early. Did that?
Yeah, but like I said, man, Mikey had a tremendous game plan and he stuck to it. You know, I didn't quite work the body enough. You know, I was throwing jabs to the body, but I wasn't working quite enough like I should have been. But, you know, he didn't have the body, but he had the fist. It was more of a clip shot, you know, a clip shot, you know, that punch didn't hurt me, you know, but he has some power, you know, but that shot wasn't the one that hurt me.
Okay, I just want to add something else as well. I've just heard, as I mentioned, what the class that Robert Easter is. He walked into Mikey's locker room on his way over here, shook the hand of every team member in Mikey's locker room and congratulated them. So that's the kind of people they are. And it's really a pleasure to work with you guys. And as I said, there will be many, many other big nights for you.
Yeah, when you're going through these training camps, you're training for a fighter, you know, they're the ultimate enemy, you know what I'm saying? Yes. But at the end of the day, you know, you went 12 hard rounds, champion versus champion. You know, you have no choice but to respect a man and his team. You know, and that's all I wanted to show Mikey, you know what I'm saying? This is a business, that's what I told him. This is a business, you know. We fought, you know, we duked it out. You know, he came out victorious, and, you know, I respect him for that.
Well, there he is. Thank you, Robert. There he is, the new unified lightweight world champion from right here, Los Angeles, Mikey Garcia.
Can't wait for your fight, Tank.
Yeah, I'm beating somebody. Damn. Say no.
Taking them all down.
You guys have any questions for Mikey?
Yeah, Mikey, you fooled me with the body, man. I thought I had one, but, you know, like I said, you know, Mike is a true champion, a true warrior.
Excuse me.
You know, he brought the best out of me. I brought the best out of him.
And you definitely also brought the best out of me. You fought very well. You gave me a good punch all the way up, just because that's the fight that I want. That's the fight that will motivate me the most.
Hey, Mike, you got here. Mike, you sure that bad, right? Congratulations on the win tonight. When you talk about Errol Spence, he came over and he spoke to some of us at ringside after the fight, and we asked him what he thought about it. And when he was concluding his remarks, he said he was licking his chops. You know, he gave you respect for being a top-notch fighter, but it seemed like you didn't think that your size would translate to where he's at. What do you think about the fact that you're both tremendous fighters, but that he's so much bigger than you?
No, that's a challenge. You know, I am moving up all the way to welterweight. You know, if I land that fight, it'll be my first attempt at welterweight, and I'm going against the top guy there, against the best in the division. I'm prepared to take on that challenge. Like I said, I'm here to challenge myself, you know, and he is the best. He might feel that it's, you know, an easy fight for him when I'm too small.
Easy work, baby.
Who's next? Who's he next? Errol Spence?
He wants Errol Spence, yeah.
What do you think about Spence, Mikey?
It'll be a good fight.
It's a badass fight.
Are you excited, Chema? Is it motivational?
It's motivation.
You got your Mr. Morales. What do you think about the fight?
Yeah, good fight. Mikey did his thing.
Good fight. What did you think?
Did you like the fight?
What'd you say? Fight. What do you think about the fight?
Oh, easy work.
Easy work. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, badass fight.
Super easy work. The sparring partners.
All work is easy work.
All right, you're next. When are you going to win your belts? They're waiting for you.
A couple years.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned, Mikey Garcia. So Ray Belzo, are you going to want to defend champion Mikey Garcia versus Errol Spence? How do you think that pans out?
Well, you know what? Styles make fights. I mean, Mike is a great fighter, man. He's doing nothing but performing great, you know what I mean? I mean, it's
it's a very interesting fight. You know, it's going up and weight, like two weight divisions. That's against him, you know, but you never know. Talent, you know, technique, you know, makes fights.
What did you make of his performance tonight?
You know what? It did great. You know what I mean? I can't say anything. He did everything right. You know, was very patient and very smart, you know. He shows his punches, he shows his shots, you know what I mean? And he did great, you know what I mean?
He's on board.
Robert Easton, you know, he came with a great game plan. You know, wasn't taking too much risk, and kept the distance well. You know, it was a great fight.
Mikey versus Loma, who wins?
I think Mikey.
You think Mikey beats Loma? What about Ray Beltran versus Loma? Champ versus champ.
I beat him.
Why do you say that?
Because you know what? Loma is a great fighter. He's a great fighter, but you know, it been matched very well. I don't think nothing away from him. I think nothing away from him. But I think Salido already beat him. Maybe people forgot about that. You know what I mean? Everybody forgot about that.
Okay.
And also Alina was doing an okay job, you know, exposed him good too. So I mean he's not a god, you know what I mean? I always believe in he can lose.
You have one belt, Mikey has two belts, Loma has one belt. So you need to unify and then fight Mikey.
Yeah, I mean, you know what? That's a great fight. I think a great fight for the fans. But you know, gotta go with do what I have to do first, and hopefully, you know, everything go great, and we find Mikey. You know what I mean?
All right, there you have it, Ray Beltran. Thank you. EsNews.com.
Thank you.
So there you have it. Another great video for EsNews. For EsNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram @EliSeckbach. Step back, now, who is Elie Seckbach?